Miss Florida in beautiful St. Petersburg, here to see the Braves play.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd.
I have loved being Miss St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg has been an amazing city to represent, and the people are so welcoming, and I absolutely love it.
How's it going? What's your name?
Katie.
Hi, Katie. I'm Christina. Oh, my gosh. I can't believe that it's almost coming to a close. In 1 week, I'll be crowning the new Miss Florida. It has been a whirlwind. It has been so much fun and a lot of self-discovery. I've learned a lot about myself this year, which will help me further my career and have a bright and rosy future.
Laura McKeeman, and most people might know me for my role on Sun Sports Rays, in which I do the pregame show and postgame show for the Tampa Bay Rays. But today, I'm taking on a different role, and that's Miss Pinellas County. I'm competing in the Miss Florida Pageant.
I wanted to ask you, how do you get fired up for a game?
Oh, you just got to get mentally prepared, really. I mean, you got to wake up, eat a good breakfast, and get ready to go. I mean, you kind of got to be self-motivated, really.
Yeah, you don't have any weird rituals that you have to do, weird dances, weird things you have to eat or drink before you get up?
No, I got to make sure I eat something good. That's all I know. I mean, I go in the gym, I work out, and I actually like to listen to music. I like to listen to music, get me pumped up, get me ready to go.
Four is one, two, three strikes, you're out of the old.
From the beautiful Mahaffey Theater in St. Petersburg, the Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen Pageant proudly presents Red, Hot, and Blue, featuring 33 beautiful, talented, and intelligent young women from across the state of Florida and a fabulous star-studded cast.
Don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up.
Competition. What do you think?
Let's do this.
Ready to bring the top 11 backstage?
That's right.
Excited to see our top 11 outstanding teen contestants have prepared for their talent presentations. So we're going to move right into talent.
Maybe she's what you prefer, but hey, last year I was her. Maybe you will change your mind, but you might look up to fine. I've gone on to better things, better jobs and bigger rings. I don't have the time to cry. I'm too busy loving my name up on that list. Kind of a cool ironic twist. Who else can I tell? Where's my cell? Mom will fall on the floor. Look at my name in black and white. Your daughter's doing something right. than before. And now, standing there with a wizard, feeling things I've never felt. And though I'd never show it, I'd be so happy I melt. And so it will be for the rest of my life, and I want nothing else till I die. Held in such high when people see me, they will scream for half of Ozzy's favorite team, the Wizard and I. Make it up, shake it up, let the fantasies begin. Here's the joke. To get cast, or change the past. Make the luck just right for sin. Let's go. Take a gamble, cause it's safe to bet. Mr. Sanic ain't seen nothing yet. When we're finished, he'll never forget. This 20th Century Fox. Make it up, shake it up. Make me feel like the main attraction. Change the clothes and fix the nose. And then 5, 6, 7, 8, action.
Action.
Now I'm gone, but I ain't so dumb.
No.
Hollywood will be under my thumb. Partners until I become
the 20th Century Fox.
We've seen fitness wear. I thought they did great. Talent blew us away. So what do you think we have left?
We've got to ask some questions and evening wear.
So it's probably our most gracious and beautiful part of this afternoon. It's our final competition, which is evening wear.
Thank you.
right, so if you are chosen Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen, first of all, what is your platform and what would you like to do to implement it across the state of Florida?
Well, my platform is the March of Dimes, which is a nonprofit organization that raises funds and awareness for premature babies and infant mortality. But not only does the March of Dimes raise awareness for that, they raise funds and awareness for 125 different other diseases. And as Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen, I want to visit all 67 counties in Florida and raise awareness about the March of Dimes.
So who do you have here who would you like to give a shout out to?
I have my family and my grandma and any other friends that I don't know are here, but I love you. Thank you for coming. It's dark, so I can't really see all of them. Thank you.
All right, and what is your platform? How would you like to implement it?
My platform is the Wounded Warrior Project, and it's very near and dear to my heart. I grew up an Army brat, and I grew around those type of people, and it's just, I really want to spread awareness to the young people of this country that we really need to take care of those that have protected us for so long. Even though they come back maybe looking a little differently, we need to take care of them, and they need to not be forgotten. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Channing. All right, we're ready for our awards. Assisting in our presentation in tonight's winners is Miss Florida Christina Hanolo and Rachel Strever, Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen for 2011.
It's time to announce our runners-up and our new Miss Florida Outstanding Teen. Rob, do we have the envelope? Ready to go. Ladies and gentlemen, the first runner-up and the recipient of a $500 scholarship, Miss Manatee County's Outstanding Teen, Channing Weir. Your new Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen, Jennifer Stalen, Miss St. John's County's Outstanding Teen. Hang on, Jennifer, they'll get the crown out there in just a moment.
You're insecure.
She looks a little shocked.
I don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you.
Exciting year ahead of her. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, your new Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen, Jennifer Stalen. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for our national anthem. It's being sung this evening by Amanda Puyat from St. Petersburg High School IB, and our colors are being presented by the United States Coast Guard Color Guard from Sector St. Petersburg.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the
plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel so paper thin, like
like a house of cards, one blow from caving in. Do you ever feel already buried deep? 6 feet under screens, but no one seems to hear a thing. Do you know that there's still a chance for you? Cause there's a spark in you. You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just
Central Florida.
Ashley.
Ashley Lewis, Miss Palm Beach County.
Amanda Harris, Miss Orlando.
Ozzo Awesome, Miss Miami.
Victoria Williams, Miss Pasco County Fair.
Liz Stiles, Miss River City.
Megan Cartaya, Miss Homestead.
Bianca Lynch, Miss University of South Florida.
Kelly Savage, Miss St. John's County.
Sarah York, Miss Orange County.
Joshua Gonzalez, Miss Dade County.
Brandis Astrina, Miss Treasure Coast.
Ashlyn Robinson, Miss University of Florida.
Ellie Ullman, Miss DeSoto Heritage Festival.
Megan Moore, Miss Clay County.
Ashley Ramsey, Miss Tampa Bay.
Rachel Hart, Miss Northeast Florida.
Janae DeLeon, Miss Boca Raton.
Marat Tessiani, Miss Gainesville.
Music Meyer, Miss Florida Sunshine.
Erin O'Flaherty, Miss Pasco County.
All right, right now 11 of you are going to take one step closer to the title of Miss Florida 2012. The scoring of tonight's competition. Each of our semifinalists was given a composite score by our judges, which will account for 30% of tonight's score. Swimsuit is 20%, evening gown is also 20%, and finally, their talent scores will be 30% this evening. As in the preliminaries, high and low scores are dropped, and the five contestants with the highest number of points will be our top five finalists. Now, the brightest firework on the stage this week is our very own Christina Hanolo. Christina began to light up the state of Florida on July 9th, 2011, when she was crowned Miss Florida. She has taken the job of Miss Florida to another level and been a model title holder for all of our state. She made us all proud when she was named as a top 12 finalist at the Miss America pageant and walked away with much pride in her performance and friendships that she'll treasure for a lifetime. Christina was a tireless advocate for the Miss Florida organization, Children's Miracle Network Hospitals, for her platform of protecting our environment for the Everglades Foundation. She will forever be our Miss Florida 2011. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Florida 2011, Christina Hanolo. Another very special young woman who is with us this week. Last August, she went to the National Miss America's Outstanding Teen Competition as Miss Florida's Outstanding Teen, and she left there with the title of Miss America's Outstanding Teen. She's been an outstanding representative for the organization as she's worked to advance their mission of scholastic achievement, creative accomplishment, healthy living, and community involvement in our nation's youth. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Miss America's Outstanding Teen, Elizabeth Bechtel. Performing performing to Hot, Hot, Hot from Go Diego Go, please give a warm welcome to all of our Miss Florida Sunshine Prince and Princesses.
Hot, hot, hot!
It's my great pleasure to welcome to the stage the executive director of the Miss Florida organization, Mary Sullivan.
That's all they'll let us say.
Thank you. Well, guess what? It's hot, hot, hot in here, and it's been hot, hot, hot all week in St. Petersburg. And we are so grateful that the weather is everything that St. Petersburg promises it will be. It has been beautiful, sunny, and just perfect for all of our family, friends, and our contestants. Thank you. St. Petersburg is very fortunate to have such great leadership at the helm, and I'd like now for you to welcome the mayor of St. Petersburg, Mayor Bill Foster.
Wait, don't run off, you can't leave.
Okay.
I don't do this without you.
Okay.
There's only one Mary Sullivan anywhere in the country. And we have her. Florida is so honored to send to the National Miss America pageant the finest, most intelligent, most beautiful person who's well represented, and Mary Sullivan is the person behind all of that. On behalf of the city, thank you.
Thank you.
And on behalf of the people of the city of St. Petersburg, welcome. Welcome to St. Petersburg, Florida and the Mahaffey Theater. We're glad you're here. We're glad that you've taken this opportunity to support the Miss Florida pageant for Miss America. And you will see the most intelligent, beautiful, and talented young women anywhere in the state of Florida right here on our stage. And it's only fitting that St. Petersburg is the number one arts and cultural destination in the entire country, according to American Style magazine. So you can clap for that, I heard. So after the pageant, if you have some free time tomorrow, please enjoy the sights of the city of St. Petersburg, the most beautiful waterfront, from the Chihuly Collection to the Dali, the Museum of Fine Arts, and all of the outdoor cafes and everything in between. Please enjoy your stay in the most beautiful city in America, and I'm partial to the city of St. Petersburg. We're also very, very honored to host this pageant every single year, and we adopt the winner. And Christina has been such an outstanding representative of this pageant, but really of the city of St. Petersburg. And then we had Jacqueline the year before, and Rachel before that. The city of St. Petersburg adopts these young ladies, and we send them off and wish them well, but we're always happy to have them come back to the city of St. Petersburg. We love this pageant. We're honored to host it. Enjoy your night. God bless you.
We're going to start out with probably one of the highlights of the evening. Things are about to get hot in the Mahaffey Theater as we move into our first phase of competition, which is lifestyle and fitness in swimsuit. Some talent.
All right, yeah, let's keep this thing moving.
What do you think?
We're ready
for some
talent competition. All right, like I said, we are moving to the talent competition. Our judges are looking for technical skills, stage presence, and a selection, costuming, and staging that all add up to great entertainment. So let's get started.
I don't feel anything unless I think of you. I don't even cry. When I open my eyes, I don't need to care. I scream, no, it doesn't hurt unless I walk. I don't feel anything unless I try to talk. I don't even cry unless I open simple complication. Miscommunications lead to fallout. So many things that I wish you knew. So many walls up I can't break through. Now I'm standing alone in a crowded room and we're not speaking. And I'm dying to know, is it killing you like it's killing me? Yeah. I don't know what to say since the twist of fate when it all broke down. And the story of us looks a lot like a tragedy now.
Next chapter.
We'll now continue our competition this evening as our contestants display beauty, style, and grace in evening wear. Our local representatives were encouraged to express their personal style in selecting a gown of their choice for tonight's final phase of competition.
The excitement continues as we get closer to announce the announcement of our top five finalists for the title of Miss Florida 2012.
This is a very exciting time. We're good to go?
We're good to go.
All right. Hi, Chloe. First, let's just let you relax a little bit. And we want to know who's out there in the audience supporting you tonight.
Oh, my goodness. Too many people to name. Thank you so much to my family and my friends and my directors. I am so thankful that I'm right here right now. This is a dream come true.
Thank you. And Jillian, why don't you give a shout out to all your fans?
First, hi Mom and Dad, thanks for the dress. And thank you everyone who came out and supporting me, all my twirling friends, all my friends from FSU. I could not have been here without you. Thank you.
Thank you. And Miss Laura, why don't you go ahead and thank your fans?
Hi Mom and Dad, I'm not sure where they are because it's too foggy so I can't see, but thanks for putting up with me doing all of this pageant stuff. It's been so much fun. This is an amazing experience. And thanks to my directors for giving me so much support. All of my friends that are here, I love all of you.
And Alexis, why don't you go ahead?
Well, obviously, Mom and Dad, I have so much family here. I can't thank you all enough for flying in and going the distance. Everyone from UCF who's come out, my amazing friends way up there. Ashley, I see you. But just thank you so much. It means so much that you're here.
And Kaylin.
Well, I just wanted to say thank you so much to everybody that came tonight. And I know some of my family is here and here and up there. And I just want to say thank you all so much for coming and being so supportive. And most importantly, thank you to the girls, because there have been so many girls that have offered to help all of us backstage. And they've really been our true support system. So thank you guys very much.
Awesome. Let's hear it for your top five. There's a lot of love in here tonight. I'll just stay right here and go ahead. And we're just gonna also want to know about your personal platform. Maybe if you have an experience, one moment that has really stood out to you this year, working with your platform, why don't you share that with the audience?
Well, my platform is acceptance of individuals with special needs. And I do have to say that the highlight of my year is actually getting to be on stage with my sunshine princess, Victoria Bettinger. I met her through the Down Syndrome Association of Jacksonville, and she was a close family friend of ours for a long time, and I just really feel a great connection with her, and she shines so much when she's on stage, and that's really a highlight of my year because I get to show her off to the world and show everyone how proud I am of her. Thank you.
All right, Alexis, I will ask the same of you. Why don't you share with the audience something wonderful about your platform?
Well, my platform is an initiative I've created called Heads Up, keeping your eyes on the road and off your phone. A goal is to reach a no texting and driving law here in our state. So my greatest accomplishment thus far is having in one single day over 1,500 signatures obtained from UCF, and we are now currently up to 3,000 signatures in support of a pledge to not text and drive. So the ultimate goal from here is to get this state to pass a law.
Thank you. All right, and Laura, why don't you tell us a little bit about your platform?
My platform is called A Royal Day, and I created it to show people in nursing homes how much we care about them and how we haven't forgotten about them. I bring tiaras, crowns, sashes, all kinds of fun things to make somebody king or queen for a day. I have learned that it sometimes works to have a whole court so we can have dukes, princes, some princesses, and it's always good to get everybody involved. And I have been so fortunate to learn so much from all these amazing people who are like living history books and offer up great experiences from their past.
Thank you. All right, and Jillian, why don't you share with us something about your platform?
Well, my platform is the Ronald McDonald House, and this year I had the opportunity to plan 80 Pieathlon, which is a whole bunch of fun relay races, all having to do with pie. I had pie in my hair for weeks, but it was so much fun. I got to raise Yeah, I got to raise awareness for all of FSU campus, as well as donate a $7,000 check to the house.
Great, thank you. And Chloe, why don't you share with us something about that you've accomplished with your platform this year?
My platform is Alcoholism in America, Think Before You Drink, and I have lost 4 people in my family to alcoholism. And I have had the opportunity to make local, state, and national contacts to make sure that I have a school-funded tour reaching 2.5 million children in Florida if I am crowned Miss Florida. So I'm really praying I have the opportunity, but I am just so blessed that I get to share my family's story and make sure that no other family in America has to go through what my family has gone through.
Okay, thank you. Well, you can see each of these ladies has a wonderful passion in their platform that they have been working for, and one of them will be your new Miss Florida. So we'll look forward to following one of your journeys over the next year.
Let's welcome back our 42 Miss Florida contestants and our cast to burn up the stage one more time.
Time to announce our 4 runners-up and our new Miss Florida for 2012. May we have the results, please?
Deep breath, everyone. Here we go. Especially to you young ladies. The 4th runner-up and winner of a $2,000 scholarship is Miss St. Petersburg, Chloe Lupo.
The 3rd runner-up and winner of a $3,000 scholarship is Miss Florida State University, Jillian Tapper.
Our 2nd runner-up and winner of $4,000 scholarship is Miss North Florida, Kaylin Dennis.
Okay, the 1st runner-up to Miss Florida will receive a $6,000 scholarship. The new Miss Florida will receive a $16,500 scholarship and the chance of a lifetime to become the next Miss America as she represents the state of Florida this coming January at the Miss America Pageant in Las Vegas. Here we go. The 1st runner-up is Miss University of Central Florida, Alexa Schmidt. Congratulations to Laura. We will look forward to seeing her. you represent the state of Florida at the Miss America pageant. And we hope you have all enjoyed the show. Thanks to our volunteers, production staff, and contestants for an outstanding pageant. Thank you so much. Good night, everyone. As you shoot across the sky.
Winning Miss Florida is something that I never thought would be a reality for me. I came into pageants by accident, and I stayed by choice because I realized that it's something that truly makes you a better person. So the fact that I could actually win is amazing to me. It really hasn't hit me yet, but I think I'm in for one of the best years of my life, and I'm so excited to give service to this organization, to this state, and to this country.